Let's get Steve Cooley on. He was the DA some years ago before Jackie Lacey. Steve, how are you?
I'm doing great, but I want to correct you on one thing. That gang member who shot someone and used a gun, he'll actually do less than 5 years. If he's sentenced to 5 years, he will only have to do a portion of that sentence before he's paroled. So this is ridiculous. Ridiculous.
Why do you think Gascon even got elected?
He got elected because George Soros and a couple of like-minded individuals from Silicon Valley poured millions of dollars of their money into his campaign. He outspent Lacey by $4 to $5 million. And money talks. And he was able to run, Gascon was able to run a tremendous number of negative ads against Gascon and positive ads about himself. And that impacted the voting public. So now we have a George Soros puppet as our DA in LA County, the largest county in the United States of America.
And have you looked at these directives? What's really dangerous in there, his new directives?
I've read all nine of them.
They're lengthy.
And they're incredibly lengthy. Some are 14, 15 pages, which is amazing for a special directive. I mean, I was with that office 40 years. I never saw one more than 2 pages. But his are lengthy. Also, they're almost incomprehensible. He cites like Berkeley law studies as opposed to the law. He is disobeying the law. He's going to unilaterally try and reduce sentences for all pending cases and go back and look at 20 to 30,000 previously sentenced cases. And if those terms of sentence to state prison exceed his new standards, he wants those cases to be recalled and resentenced and reduced so they can be sentenced according to the George Gascon rules. I'm calling the guy George, quote, Soros, unquote, Gascon, because that's who he is. He's just replicating the George Soros playbook for the criminal justice system.
Well, this is going to make our streets pretty dangerous.
It's
inevitable.
Does he have the power legally to do this?
I don't think so. And I think a lot of judges don't think so. My understanding is that a lot of Superior Court judges, when deputy DAs come in, and following Gascon's order, make some of these motions to dismiss, motions to strike enhancements, pursuant to what Gascon has told them, the judges are saying, well, counsel, well, you know, Madam DA, you're saying you're doing this in the interest of justice? I don't think so. Motion denied. So the judges are so far protecting the public at large from the worst impact of Gascon's orders.
He's already been doing that because he's only been in office for a few days.
He has been doing it since 12:02 p.m. on Monday. He issued those 9 directives. Since then, he's issued 3 more.
And they've already, the deputy DAs have gone to court requesting these sentences shortened?
Absolutely. Well, they started. As soon as he said it, he issued those directives at 12:02, they were bound to follow his directive. Now, that's the hard choice is, are they going to disobey directives by the elected boss, or are they going to violate their oath and violate the law and risk discipline with the state bar because what he's telling them to do is illegal, unethical, and perhaps unconstitutional.
Why is it
he's
illegal?
Making up like, his own laws?
I've never heard of this situation where you have hundreds, thousands of cases that have already gone to trial. A judge has issued a sentence. Prisoner is in prison, and then years later, they try to reopen the case, but not because there's new evidence or anything of that nature. It's just that this DA has a different philosophy. So, what's the law says he can't?
You've never heard of it because it never happened before. This guy is doing things that are extraordinary is not even enough of a word. They are extraordinary. They are illegal. And there's going to be a lot of litigation over this. He will eventually lose because you know what? He is not the state legislature. He cannot remake the laws. He has sworn an oath to uphold the laws. And he started violating his oath within 2 minutes of taking that oath. This is a phenomenon of biblical proportions.
All right, can you hang on, Steve?
Sure.
Yeah, this is the best person that we could get to talk to. This is former Los Angeles County District Attorney Steve Cooley, the predecessor to Jackie Lacey. In fact, he was the mentor to Jackie Lacey, who became our DA for a couple of terms. But now it's George Soros' George Gascon. And he issued all these directives on Monday when he took office, and they are dangerous. And they're going to make our streets dangerous. And he doesn't want to send anybody to prison or jail. In fact, he wants to release people out of jail or prison who've already been sentenced. Steve is giving us his opinion that this is reckless and illegal. And we'll ask him more when we come back.
John and Ken Show, KFI.